Hi, I'm Jose Porro, founder and CEO of Cobalt Water Global. I'm here on location in New York City for Climate Week NYC, where events, meetings, and talks are being held each year to inspire global climate action. However, this year marks a year for greater urgency in climate action. For those who have not yet started to take action, 2021 has been a wake-up call, a code red, as others have put it. Because if in 2019 we declared a climate crisis, in 2021 we can declare a climate war. Because with war comes death and destruction. And this year we have had plenty of climate-related death and destruction around the world. Even here in New York City, with extreme flooding as recently as a few weeks ago. We're actually fighting for the other side by adding carbon into the atmosphere from burning fossil fuels, driving non-electric, inefficient vehicles, inefficient buildings, carbon-intensive supply chains, the list goes on and on. Greenhouse gas emissions touches everyone. Therefore, it has to be everyone taking action. Us at home, NGOs, governments, corporations, startups working on climate change, we need entrepreneurship to scale our impact and scale it fast. In the water sector, there are a lot of opportunities. However, relatively speaking, there's been very little action. There are leaders paving the way, like the water utility here in New York City and water utilities in the Netherlands, Denmark, in Australia, and in the UK, where they set a target to be net zero by 2030. However, the rest of the water community can no longer watch and wait. It's time to get in the game. The US is back in the game by re-entering the Paris Agreement, and the US water sector needs to follow. And there are some quick wins in the water sector. There are some small things that we can do today that can have a big impact. For example, nitrous oxide, or N2O, which is a potent greenhouse gas and is emitted from water reclamation facilities all over the world, tens of thousands, if not more. However, only a few are mitigating N2O. And we have the knowledge, we have the technology and the tools to stop N2O emissions today. The N2O is just one of many examples. I debated whether to use the analogy to war because it can have a negative connotation. But I thought back to something that Corinne Trumsdorf, CEO of Water Cities, said during last year's World Water Day. She said that the effects of climate change are so serious that we have to treat it like it's a fight. I agree with this mentality because we're literally fighting for our lives. And with war, there can be hope. If we look back at some of the wars that have been fought, they've been fought with the hope of achieving good, like freedom, end of persecution, fighting for life. It's no different with climate change. There is hope, hope for a better future, freedom from the rule of extreme heat and climate disaster. One of the biggest challenges of winning a war is that we cannot control what our enemy does. With climate change, we are our own enemy, which is promising because we can control what we do. So we need to use this to our advantage and start taking action. Go on the offensive. We have plenty of weapons. Now it's just a matter of using them, and using them today. Thank you. Stay safe.